Nobody takes down Angel Snuff Nuff 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody want to get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. But you don't take me seriously, and now your ass is barbecue.
Now, what was that you were saying earlier, T?
What I was saying was, what you do?
What you do?
Where you at?
Where you at?
Oh, you got plans?
Oh, you got plans?
Don't say that.
Shut your trap.
Unless you hear.
Unless you hear.
At the spot.
At the spot.
We got a show.
We got a show.
It's gonna be hot.
It's gonna be hot.
So if you feel the way we feel and you wanna come party tonight, baby, tell us that you're coming through.
We gon' leave the door open.
We gon' leave the door open.
We gon' leave the door open, y'all.
We gon' leave the door open, open.
Y'all coming?
Come on through.
Come on, y'all. We wanna see you.
It's going down tonight, what? Y'all.
black people. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody.
We are in a state of emergency.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly.
Now you won't believe this.
What?
It's a you know we were just talking about people finding friends on the internet, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, you know that's what my ministry. You know I have a ministry and stuff I do on the internet. So I have people that I associate with, and I was talking to this brother. I'd have known him for what, a few years now. What, about 4 years? Talking on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, he came here. He came here and we visited and saw each other in person.
Really?
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, he came and spent the weekend here.
And with you or just in St. Louis there?
No, he came and stayed with me.
Really?
Yeah.
You better be careful of stuff like that now.
No, I told
you. People that meet on the internet and stuff. Oh, God, you don't know what people are up to now.
You can meet people in person and still go through the same crap. Ain't no
difference. Like now, you can't really trust nobody. Especially, don't be letting them stay at home and stuff.
Yeah.
God. Yeah, you can't get rid of them, too. I mean, people there, they come just a visit. They don't want to leave.
Well, right. They came for a visit.
Uh-huh.
2-3 years ago.
Get rid of them.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Especially if you pay for everything, shoot. They
yeah.
Don't want, uh-uh, you can't get rid of them.
But I was talking.
Anyway, go ahead with it.
Yeah, but I was talking to him, and he mentioned that ex-wife thing of mine. You remember that woman that I'm supposed to be married to? And we were just talking, and he brought her name up, and he was telling me about, now he don't know that I had any association with this woman. He was talking to me, and I thought it sounded like her, and he just started describing her. Then I'm like, you know, I'm like, that's that woman. And she did him the same way she did me, wanted him to come, you know, and live with her in Toledo and stuff like that, and you know, the same thing. But he didn't fall for the old okie doke like I did.
Oh, you said, "What I got to lose?" Told you.
Yeah, I said, "What I got to lose?"
Find out what you got to lose. Uh-huh.
Well, I figured, you know, I figured, you know, she wasn't my type, cause you know I don't like fat chicks. I don't care about no fat chick. But I thought I'm willing to look over that because we had good conversation on the phone, and I was willing to overlook the fact that she had a house full of children and she was fat and whatever. I'm willing to overlook that because I thought she might be a nice person and just, and, you know, go see where it goes. I said, what I got to lose? Oh, boy. That turned out to be a bad mistake. You know, because, you know, on the phone, and, you know, when you first meet people, they put on their best show. You know, their best.
They sure do. They sure do. That's like when you're courting, it's the same thing, too. You at your best. Always. You at your best.
Yeah, you at your best. Mm-hmm. And also.
Men or women, it doesn't matter, whatever. Both of them, you try to be at your best.
Yeah. And another thing, she was sickly. She had just had a back problems or something like that. So she was very docile, you know, in pain and stuff, whatever. Once she started getting well over that, whole different ball game. The real her started coming out. You could already see it the way she bossed those children around. You know, unless I'm sick, I don't need nobody to go get me anything. You know, if you want to cook, I come down to the kitchen and get my. I don't need to sit in front of a TV watching TV and talk about, you know, clap my hands, you know, like I'm some kind of king or queen, you know, serving. Go give me my food. Go give me. That's the way she was. She'd sit there and.
You mean with her children?
Yeah, those girls.
Oh, so she really had them like, under control. You know, you find some women, I don't know, they got their children really under control. And
yeah.
Where they really mind them. They really are what I consider good children. But, you know, sometimes you overdo it. You like use them
mm-hmm.
when it's unnecessary, you know, to do to your own children and stuff.
Well, that's what she
but
was
anyway,
doing.
But anyway, you have all kinds of people.
Well, that's what she was doing, and she got like 9 children or whatever.
Wait, I thought she just had the 3 daughters.
Her own children, she got about 9. She got like 7
oh
girls.
My God.
She got 7 girls and 2 boys.
What?
She been wow. married. She been married about 7 times.
Wow! Wait a minute. You knew that before you went there?
No, I didn't know. I didn't know she was married 7 times.
Oh my God! Really?
She got and 5 of the girls escaped her plantation, and they got out of her plantation. She hates their guts. They moved. They got away from her because they got tired of that slave life. They wanted to learn how to live life. They got tired of, you know, she's overly obsessed with Elijah Muhammad. Every other word, you know, she talking about pancakes. You know, Elijah Muhammad like pancakes. I'm like, what? Lady, they don't have
no. She wasn't over obsessed with. No, she had her own thing made up in her head, how things are and stuff. And
mm-hmm.
And nobody under the messenger was going to invite no man mm-hmm. to live with her.
Mm-hmm.
No, we didn't do that. We weren't taught that. I know that was a lie right there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where she got that from. Might have come from Wallace. She sure didn't come from another like mama. No way hell. No, she is a liar.
Well, that's what
from get go. That's her own Islam she made up.
Yeah, that's what I said, because I never heard of that myself.
You know, no. No way.
Yeah, she got her own version.
Yeah, you developed your own thing, what you like. Oh, you mean this and you mean that. That's for you. We do a whole lot of things just to keep our own dirt going.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like you say, you're using somebody's name, good name, to cover your dirty stuff that is like the deck on Jews. You know, but a whole lot of people do that and everything.
This woman.
I know that was no. she didn't get that thing.
Didn't you talk to her?
She would be thrown out of the nation if she did some shit like that.
Of course. The original nation.
Yes.
But you know, a lot of those people was doing stuff like that, you know, behind. They wasn't doing it in open, but in their own private home. They was drinking and smoking and doing a whole lot of stuff.
Yeah, still celebrating Christmas stuff too.
Yeah.
I know everybody, right? That's why everybody come for a different reason.
Yeah.
And some people just taking it because they figure they ain't going to see you outside and stuff, or you ain't going to see them and stuff. So, yeah, they do whatever they can to get, you know, like to cover themselves and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But once like the top find out about it, then your ass is cast out. And you know it.
Yeah, because
I know some brothers and sisters that have been put out of the mouth right there for their adultery.
Mm-hmm.
They're just thinking out and know they're not supposed to know. No, you don't even court nobody like that.
No, you
have a chaperone.
This woman had me. Okay, the first day I was at her house, she gave me her bed, right? She jumped her fat ass in the bed the next day.
What's wrong with that people? What you call her? She looks fat. She looks fat to me down
there.
Picture,
he's fat. Oh, yeah, she fat.
Nah.
She about 300 pounds.
Huh?
She about 300 pounds. She never would get on a scale.
Hey, but on that picture, she's not that big, though, right? She wasn't no 300 pounds on that picture. Do you remember the picture you sent with that? That was a beautiful picture. I love that picture, I must say.
Oh, she's three.
That's a beautiful picture.
Yeah, it's a beautiful picture, not a beautiful person. Yeah. All those girls.
Maybe not inside, but outside. To me, there were some beautiful girls too, young girls.
Yeah.
She was a beautiful person to me. I mean, looks.
Yeah, looks.
Like it's your personality and who you truly are. You know, that really come and see. I don't know her for that. I didn't know for the pictures. Just the picture. I think that's it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you didn't really couldn't really see the picture because she's wearing, you know, like a bed sheet dress. You know. It's the truth. It ain't. It's not like I'm upset and angry. I'm just telling how it was a bed sheet. You know, she got to
but
go.
You are putting a lot of that in there because you have this anger toward her. Stuff.
And she was next.
You know, because of the way things worked out, but you know, that's something you have to just get over. Let it go.
Yeah, she was a nasty, nasty. You know, she stole my money. She went. I was outside. Something told me to take my keys with me, but I left those keys in that house. I went outside to shovel the snow. She got my keys, found the one to my safe, went in with my safe and stole my money.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, she's a thief. And in the end, not only did she steal my money, she stole my Walmart bath towels. She said she didn't even like. I don't go to Walmart. I go to, you know, she here you are living in a Section 8 house, but you're going to tell me about buying all these high end. You know, you got people that's poor that'll spend their last dime trying to buy crap only rich people can afford because it don't mean nothing to them.
Yeah.
But here she are, she's saving up, getting all her little dime to buy a high-end purse. And yeah, but you got a $500 purse wearing $10 shoes. That don't make any sense to me in a $10 house.
Yeah, you got people like, I said, it's like, I don't know what you're like. I like to put on a show.
Yeah.
You need something where want to show like other people there's something that's not.
Yeah.
You know, but... I don't understand.
I don't get that either.
Yeah, I don't either. But you got a whole lot of people like that. And they ain't got a dime.
Don't have a dime.
Yeah. But they got that dream. And they try to portray that out as much as they can. Or talk it.
Yeah.
You know? Like they got this and they got this. And they're this and they're this. And they ain't nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You're just a fool. Trying to be something you're not. Just be you. Why can't you just be you? Ain't nothing wrong with cheap stuff. Cheap stuff just good as expensive stuff to me. You know?
Yeah.
Stuff is stuff.
Stuff Stuff is stuff. Well, you talked to her. You probably have an idea what I was dealing with. Didn't you talk to her on the phone?
I didn't talk to her. I talked to her, once or something. When she come telling me, you the matriarch of the family. She gonna tell me who. Matter of fact, I had never heard that word before, like not used in our family anyway,
right.
Matriarch and all that stuff.
Yeah,
but she gonna tell me I was, I don't know how that be, because is she going on, she didn't know me from Adam's, right?
Yeah.
To tell you leave her alone and what you did to her, and I don't know, some stupid stuff.
Yeah.
I ain't paying woman no attention. I mean, you're two grown folks.
Yeah.
If you can't sit down and talk to each other, you don't belong together. Or nowhere around you. Just leave them.
And that's that's what I done.
Separation. That's what it's supposed to be.
But
when that time we're too old, you're supposed to be the matured. And
right.
Talk about whatever problem you have.
That's right. And we talked about that too. We said, just let bygones be bygones. I can go my way, you can go your way. But that's not what happened. Going my way, and you went into my safe and stole my money. You don't cross lines. She crossed lines when she did that. And not only that, she called the police on me, talking about I was stalking her, cyber stalking her, or doing some crap to her. Making a false police report. Now here I am. When she made that, she thought that I was still living with her daughter that I had befriended. When she made that police report, I was on the East Coast driving a truck, going up and down the East Coast. So how am I stalking you? How am I messing with you, lady? I'm on a truck. My company can give you the records. I'm on the East Coast. I'm hundreds and hundreds of miles away from you. And she stole my bath towel. She stole my money. She put stuff on my credit card, talking about she was going to pay for it, didn't pay for it. She stole my coat, and she stole my hat for a man. There's no men in that house. Why you need a man's coat and hat? Well, the coat and hat was expensive. One of her relatives or friend gave me that. Did not give it to her. Gave it directly to me. Say, hey, man, can you use, I can't use this hat and coat. You want it? And she wants the hat and the coat simply because it has value. It's a very expensive type, coat and hat. She did, telling lies, she couldn't let it go like that.
If you figure, you seen where, this happened and stuff in the beginning, don't you think it was time for you to move out? Get away from
them? I didn't, at the time, you try, This is what happens when you're dealing with people like that. They get you caught up in their ups and downs. I understand people that go through abuse because that abuser, they can be nice. Then they smile and skin and grin for a little while. Then they go back into that crap.
Yeah.
And that's how they get you hooked for a while. Now, she didn't physically beat me up, but she did. She is a verbal abuser. Because she tried to force me to believe in Elijah Muhammad. Now, I let go of religion and stuff way back when I was locked up. I stopped believing in religion and stuff. I don't care nothing about that stuff. Way back in 2004. I didn't meet this woman until 2013. There's no way I told her. Now, I do wear my bow tie and stuff sometimes because I bought it. That's why I wear my bow tie. And my suit, because I bought it. That's the reason why. So she see me in a bow tie in my suit and think that I'm supposed to be still want to be a Muslim. No, I wear my bow tie and my suit because I bought it and I like it. I let people know from the very get-go, I don't try to put on no show. I'm not no Muslim. I don't do that no more. I'm not into religion no more. But in her delusion of mind, I'm some kind of Nation of Islam stuff or whatever. Lady, I'm not that. I don't do that no more. And when we met, she knew I wasn't that. Why would I tell her that? I'm not that. Never have been that. Haven't been that since I left the, you know, since I was locked up. I stopped believing in that because God didn't do nothing for me when I was locked up. I, you know, God was on trial when I was locked up. I called to Allah. Allah didn't do nothing for me. Jesus, I called for Jesus. I even called for the devil. He didn't show up either. I'm like, something's wrong with this stuff. You know, that's my experience. I can't speak for nobody else. And that's what my ministry is about. My ministry is about other people who think the way that I think. You know, if you want a Muslim or FOI person, you need to find somebody who think that way. I never thought that way. I never put on no show like I did think that way. I'm not that. And then, you know, she told my friend that one of my sisters here filed a police report on me talking about I molested their child. And, you know, back then. I'm like, where you getting that stuff from? That's what she told him about me.
Really?
Yeah. She sees that she's just a liar. And she said the reason why I ended up at her house because I was running from the law because the police here was looking for me because I had charges on me for child molestation. And I went to her house to escape the law. That's the stuff that she's telling people. Is
you still have contact with her?
No, I don't have no contact with her. That's what she told him. I like I told you. He didn't know I knew her, and I didn't know he knew her either. We just was talking, and he said, "Yeah, man." He was talking about this woman. And I'm like, "That sound like this that dingbat that I used." He said, "Oh man, I feel so sorry for you." He said, "You was married to her?" I like, "Oh," I said, "not no real marriage. We didn't have no real marriage. One of them fake religious type marriages. Cause in order to have a marriage, you have to be, as far as the law is concerned, it has to be recorded in a you know, one of these courts, and that never happened."
Then?
No, never happened.
Oh, I thought you did.
Mm-mm, no, we didn't go to no court. One of them fake religious type wedding. And on
when
top of that,
married?
Huh?
Where did you get married? I thought you did. Where did you get
married? No, I don't think we signed some papers and had the papers notarized. Saying,
really?
You know, the papers said, "I love you, you love me, we together," and he notarized it. That's what the it wouldn't even know it was a made up marriage license.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my God! I thought you were just courthouse or something.
Oh, I would be in big trouble.
I'm telling you. Oh, so you didn't realize getting no darn divorce and crap like that?
No.
Oh. No. Oh, shoot.
No.
So you know, right there, she ain't no damn Muslim anyway.
No. No.
We don't go to stuff like that. No.
Because, you know, in my mind, I'm thinking if she a Muslim, because, you know, I've been around you and all the brothers and sisters in the temple. You know, I've been around the mosque, you know, MGTs all my life.
Not married or something like that.
Yeah, but she don't.
That is crazy. No. Anyway, yeah, that whole thing with you. Oh, dang. I can't believe you ever. Oh, shoot. Anyway. Anyway, later for all that stuff. Let me forget about that stuff.
Yeah, I know.
So fine. So fine. Blow my mind. So fine. So fine. Blow my mind.
When the sun Thank you.